at your album release, you play with Cardi B. Make this pistol blow my way, I call it Hennessy. I know your mama taught you love my voice.
So play on me, bitch.
Whatever we buy, through this employee's purchase process, and we get 15% off the stock price. We get 15% off the lowest stock. When the pandemic hit, Nike went from being like $97.
What's going on, YouTube? AGV King Raw. I just came to the Nike store and got me a little pickup. Can't wait to get back to the crib and discuss these. But yeah, Brazils. On the way to the highs. Just got my pair of Brazils. I guess they got a whole pickleball challenge going on out here. Had to wake up early to get them, but I got them. And now I can't wait to get back to the house and show you guys. Oh wow. These look just like the Burgundy Crush SB Dunks that come out on the night.
Texas, I'm too turned up.
Oh shit. What is that, the reverse? You got your pair today? You got a pair today out of Brazil? The Brazils,
right?
Yeah.
Brazil, yeah.
Yeah, I just got them. You got them today? No?
No.
Oh, okay.
Got it,
they still right down the street. Hold on. I do the YouTube.
Yeah, this are nice.
I do the YouTube thing. You mind?
Oh, yeah.
No, okay. Yeah, man.
Oh, yeah.
Had to lace them. Yeah, man. And I like the material on this one, too. Like, I had to give it. It was one pair that they gave me. I gave it back to him, but this is the second one I tried.
Yeah. Yeah. No, this are better.
Yeah.
The material is better than the new ones. The last release, the Rebirth ones.
Yeah, this looks a little bit more cheaper.
Yeah.
This looks cheaper and this looks more.
This one, yeah. A little bit.
A little bit
the
better.
The quality, yeah.
Yeah.
No, this is nice. This is a fire.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Okay, y'all selling it?
Yeah, $475.
Oh, okay.
It's expensive right now.
No, my guy is selling it for $400, but he's sold out.
Yeah.
He's sold out.
And the remaining brand.
You got those?
Yeah.
$520.
Yeah. Size 8, 9, 10, and a half, 11.
What? All right. You say you got pairs of like 11?
11, yeah.
Can I see the 11 real quick? Let me see the 11 real quick. Hell yeah. I was hoping that they did the shock drop yesterday, but I see they didn't do the shock drop. So now Nike is going to be backed up on the 17th. They're going to be backed up on the 17th because they didn't do no shock drop for them.
Yeah, the 17th.
Yeah, yeah. So when they do release,
they're
yeah. I'm praying they actually release.
Yeah.
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 Because I don't think they are going to. Yeah, so I'm about to get a chance to check out the Reimagined Brand 4s before they release. It's like 2 weeks before. I guess I came out here for a reason. God is good. I can't complain. Oh man, I can't wait to see him real quick. I can't wait to see him. I'll tell you the truth. I can't wait to see him. Yeah. What am I looking at?
Me.
Yeah. Thank you guys for watching. I really appreciate all the love, man. I can't. Yeah, I'm about to see the Bread of Reimagined Forest. But yeah, I came down here for these. Ended up getting my pair. Like he said, these are way better material than the reverse vibes. And I like them with the white laces and not the yellow laces. But yeah, man, just a pickup for the day. I really like these. I'm glad I got my pair, and my pair is not messed up or like no issues on it, no glue, no mess. Like I seen on another pair that the front box was a little bit like dented in and stuff like that. Yeah, thank you, sir. This is what we all waiting for. This is what we all waiting for. The Bread Reimagined 4. They got, it's a regular, it's normal just like before. The only difference is the leather that's on that toe box and the leather wrapping around the shoe. But this leather feels so good, it don't make sense. This is the little hang tag. But damn. Even the tongue is leather. Leather all around the shoe with the OG Nike Air sign on the back. This tab is a little bit hard. I thought it might be a little bit softer like the SB versions, but this is a little bit solid. It's solid. It's not bad at all. I think this is definitely a cop. Definitely a cop. Two pair if you could. But yeah, that's the Bread Reimagined 4. That's the guys. Thank you. I appreciate that. This is Sneaker Lovers, right?
Yeah, Sneaker Lover Dumb Miami on Instagram.
Sneaker Lovers, wait, what?
It's on Instagram, Sneaker Lover Dumb Miami.
Sneaker Lovers Miami. Dot Miami on Instagram. They got some hard shit in here. What type of dunks we got? We got the Brazil dunks. If you look right there, I don't know what it's gonna say, but I'll tell you right now. Varsity Maze, Pine Green, and White. Size 11 and a half, of course. That's what size I wear. But before I open the box, I want to talk to y'all about how I got the shoe. Because they actually dropped today. They released today, February 2nd. But when I woke up this morning, my initial idea was to order them directly off that sneakers app. But I know how that sneakers app be. So you know what I did? Oh, let me not tell you that. I gotta keep some of the secrets to myself. I can't tell you how I found out where they. I ain't telling y'all none of that. Look, so I woke up this morning. My initial idea was to get on the app and bottom off the app. So last night I made like two new accounts. I put one account on one phone, one account on the other phone. I put one account on a laptop. I'm like, all right, when I wake up, I'm gonna just go on all three of them, and I'm gonna just try to get them on all of them. I wake up at 10:35, all of them are sold out already. They released at 10 o'clock. Now, I don't know how Nike says that they don't got bots no more, but who was up at 10 a.m. buying the whole stock of shoes? I understand if you buy all 11 or 11 and a half or 12. These are sizes that's going to resell. Who bought all the 8s, the 7s, the 7 and a halves? Who bought all that? And it's not even, and the crazy thing is, like, I go to the sneaker resellers that I know, and I go on their page, right? And they'll be like, oh, we got Miami Dolphin dunks for $180, $200. And I'm looking at the dunks like, okay, I can see why they would be worth $200. But then I go to Nike this morning, and they still got the Miami Dolphins on the wall. So what that tells me is that it's insane how these resellers are, like, it's like the people who buy resale shoes don't even look on a Nike app or don't even go on sneakers app. But the people who go on the sneakers app got bots. So it's like the people who go into the stores, they're regular consumers. They probably don't even really, they don't even know what new shoe is about to come out. But the people that's on the sneakers app, it's like they're doubled down on when these shoes are going to release and how many bots they actually need to purchase all of them off the shelves. Because it's crazy how all these sneakers, what's something? was something. Even these. Even these. You go on the sneakers app, it's sold out. You go online, they're sold out. You go to the resellers, and they got these for $160, $180, something like that. And that's cool, because if you ain't buy it off the shelf, then I understand why the resale value will be up a little bit more. But at the end of the day, people who actually want the shoe don't even get a chance to get the shoe because they're at work. They're at work or they're doing something that's important, because when they do release the 10 a.m. On sneakers app, it's all bought it up. They're all bought out. So any sneaker, if you do pay attention to the sneakers app, get in the comments and you let me know how many times you actually got on that app and got what you wanted. And then tell me if the shoe sold out the next day or that same day. Because if you actually got what you wanted, 9 times out of 10, that shoe ain't even sold out. So the dopamine release that you got from buying the shoe was cool for you. But what they're doing is increasing the dopamine releases for the average consumer that actually wants these off the sneakers app. But you got the average consumer versus the bought it out. You get what I'm saying? So you're it's like people versus a machine. That's what it is. And unless you actually got the time of day to go to a store when the sneaker actually releases, you'll never get the chance to actually buy it. That's why you're paying that extra $50. That's why you're paying that extra $60. That's what it is. So I understand if the shoe is actually sold out, why it would cost a little bit more. But at the end of the day, I don't understand how people are not getting the chance to even buy the shoe. How many bots do you buy for the shoe to be sold out? But back to the topic of the day. What I got for y'all today is the Brazils. Beautiful. And this is the second pair, right? Well, this ain't the second pair that I got. This is the second release. The first release is, of course, 2020. But this release, when I got to the store this morning, I woke up, like I said, 10:30, 10, whatever. And I'm like, okay, yeah, the store opened at 11. I'm going to go down there. I'm going to get them. Come to find out, the store was open 30 minutes early because they had like a whole pickleball court going on out there. I'll put some video, some image of that. And then, but they had a lot going out there. So it was open 30 minutes early, but they still had my pair. So, but this is the second pair that I touched, because the first pair I got, like, they had a whole bunch of like glue marks, and it was like scuffs on the shoe a little bit, and it was like thick glue like right here. So if you did get any pairs like that, like what do they call it? Like quarantine pairs? If you got any like quarantine pairs like that with any issues, get in the comment box, let me know about that too. Because he told me when the Cement 3s dropped, they had like 800 pair that was quarantined, and they couldn't even sell the shoes. So you let me know if you actually got a pair of those that was like super messed up or whatever. Because with these pair, one thing I did do is as soon as I left this store, I went to another store called Shoe Lovers, I think it was called. Shoe Lovers Miami. So, and what I did was I compared this shoe to the reverse Brazil. And I'll put some image of that too. But basically, what I noticed is the materials that they use on this shoe is way better than the material that they use on the reverse Brazils. And honestly, I don't even like the reverse for Brazils. I don't know if it's because of the white laces and the yellow lace swap. I don't know. But I don't like them. I stick with these. I do like these. I'm not even gonna lie. I was in the clearance store back in December, like before Christmas, and one of the dudes that was working in the clearance store, he had these on. And I was like, those are cool as hell. And he was like, oh, they release again soon. I wake up and they're sold out. So basically, what I think about these sneakers is I think they're super cool. I think they're super cool. I think the material is perfect. I think that, like, when you talk about the material from the early 2000s to the material now, I can understand why you say, oh, it's like, it seems like a cheaper dunk. Like, the dunk seems like a cheaper shoe. But at the end of the day, this does not seem like a cheaper shoe to me. Like, at the end of the day, even if I were to compare this dunk to something that I just, the one I just pulled out. Okay, I don't know if y'all can actually see this, but can you see how tight that is? You see how tight that material is? Now when you look at this material, do you notice how loose this is? like, do you notice it's a little bit more tumbled? I don't know if I'm tripping, but this leather is a little bit more tumbled than this leather. Is a little bit more tumbled. Than this leather. And I really don't even like this shoe. I just kept it because my mom told me she liked it. So, and I couldn't return it. I really don't even like this shoe. But it's here. But when you look at the two shoes, you can notice that the material on this, the yellow and the green, is way more tumbled than the red and the green on this right here. Other thing that I notice about these shoes is that there's little mishaps, like the glue being all around that toe box. That glue is kind of thick. And then when I go to this shoe over here, it's like, this is like a little split here. And then when I come over here, I don't know what that is. But it's like little stuff. It's not crazy. But it's like a big conversation that I was having with the people in the sneaker store was if the materials that are on the sneakers now are better or worse than the materials that was originally on the Dunks. And I'm not going to lie to you. I know that a majority of the Dunks are, like, the material is not going to be as good as you expected. And it's probably because these are being mass produced. Like, when they used to make Dunks, they only made it for the teams, or they only made it for like a specific amount of pairs. They went from making like almost like maybe 60,000 or 70,000 pairs to 500,000 pairs. Like, so what would you expect? I don't know what people expect, but it's like, you gotta go for shoes that you actually want. You can't go for everything. You gotta go for what you actually want, because 9 times out of 10, like, bruh, a shoe is a shoe, right? A shoe is a shoe. What are you expecting from it, right? You're paying $115 for a shoe, right? And your main conversation is the material on the shoe? If that's your main conversation, like, you're acting like they're using plastic, or you're acting like it's not, I don't know. If you get what I'm saying, jump in the comment box. But this is a shoe that's not really in demand. This is a shoe that's in demand. The material that they use on this shoe is different than the material they use on this shoe. And to me, it's obvious. And to me, I understand why. These are probably going to sit on the shelf. These are sold out. But that's exactly what I'm saying to you. Like, if you're talking about material, you really gotta, you, 9 times out of 10, you're probably talking about your pair. But if you, yeah, of course, if you put this against a 2020 pair, the 2020 pair was like $500-$600 2 days after the release. It's not because of the material. It's because of the amount they released. That's why. Like, you can't take a material conversation and then put it to a limited release conversation. That's two different conversations. The Dunk is not a bad shoe because it's being mass produced. I understand if not all the leather is being tumbled like this, but it's like, what are you going for? A lot of these are like, in all reality, what are you going for? Because people that know what they're going for, people that know the shoes, they know which ones are going to be good materials. They know which ones are not going to be bullshit. Like, you talk to me about materials and you talk to me about sneakers, and I don't think it has to do with Dunk at all. I think it has to do with Nike, period. And when I pull this one out, there's nothing that a person can tell me about the materials. You can't tell me nothing about the material, because your conversation ain't based on material. Your conversation is based on limited releases. That's why you're talking, because you don't have a pair. That's why. And that, I don't know. That, me personally, that's what I think. Because a lot of the people, even the people that do have a pair of the 2020 releases of these, they'll talk about the material, but you're still buying them. So if you're still buying them, I don't know nothing else to tell you. But what I'm going to do now is Look, I'll talk more about the shoes. They got the green bottom. They wrapped around the outer sole with the white. The green and yellow goes stupid. The way I laced it up, to get in the comment box, let me know what you think, because you know how I rock my you know how I rock them. But I only laced one because I did that while I was still in the store having a conversation. But get in the comment box, let me know what you think. Did you get a pair? Do you like your pair? Do you not like the material? What do you think about it? Are you selling it? Do you want to keep it? I know I'm not selling these. These are probably going to sit with me for a little bit. Because I actually like the shoe. I like this shoe way more than I like this shoe. I wish I can give this away. I wish I can give this away. But I actually like this shoe. So these ain't going nowhere. But get in the comment box. Let me know what you think. Subscribe.